Seton Hall is to get back in the win column tonight. Seton Hall in the white, Oregon in the green, and we're underway from Omaha. Vince Welch and Nick Baugh.
Far too much. I think they really missed Peyton Pritchard. And then Will Richardson out. There's a turnover to get things started.
Reynolds leaves it for Roden.
Seton Hall getting a pick six turnover right away.
Long three from Eric Williams. Missed it, but the rebound pulled down by Jonte. And the feed right back to Williams and the terrific block from Obiaju.
At the Pac-12 level and at Oregon. And I think he does a lot of the same things, but he really values length and athleticism at this level. I've been really impressed with the level of athlete that he's got.
Omaruyi with the three-pointer.
Javar Reynolds is more of a pass-first, tough point guard.
Duarte on the bounce. Drives it in, feeds, and the finish.
Hit the ground running. A lot on this guy's plate. Amari Hardy, the UNLV grad transfer, having to start at the point guard spot.
Three from Williams.
Against George Mason when he was at Duquesne. So he is capable of having big scoring nights from beyond the arc.
And Miles Kale for the Oregon Ducks, the transfer from St. John's, just received his NCAA waiver and eligibility this week.
Got to find a way to establish Mamu Kalashvili if you're Seton Hall.
Yeah, it's been very quiet so far as that one goes in and out by Kale. Mamu really hasn't had many touches. Nicely done. Omaruri gets another basket for Oregon. Let's see if Seton Hall can get Mamu a touch inside, and the attempted dunk by Samuel was blocked from behind. Three from Terry. Got it. They're not hitting, but haven't gotten many easy looks, that's for sure. Long three from Samuel. That's what they needed. Figueroa, and now Williams strong to the basket. Big collision, and Seton Hall comes away with the numbers. Molson lobs it for Samuel. Molson for three.
Backside screen to free up a three-point shooter.
And Lawson answering for the Ducks. They got the clock taken care of. You saw that on that previous replay that it, for a while, the clock just wasn't running. It dropped us down back under 9 minutes. And there's the three-pointer from Molson. After Seton Hall started 2 of 12, they've made their last four. It's amazing just making some shots, what that does for you. Three on the way from Hardy. Missed it. Dante with the offensive rebound. Going to give the Ducks another chance. Now they throw it away. Terrific defense and the finish.
Gotten Seton Hall back into this game. It's just being more active on the defensive end.
Hardy will try it from the opposite side this time, and he hits it. We got off to a slow start in the first half of that game against Rhode Island on Wednesday as well, and then finally heated up toward the latter stages of the first half and ended up having a terrific game as Duarte
trailer. And you can hear it, so you understand where your teammates are at.
Oh, Mamu finally gets one. Terrific effort on the save, but saves it right into the hands of Seton Hall, and they've got the numbers for Roden, and he missed the dunk.
You wonder why Kevin Willard has no hair. You hit a dunk and he doesn't get it to go
down. Four on one. And Omaruyi answers, makes him pay for the miss at the other end. Nice shot fake in the dish. Finds the open man, but he kicks to the wing now for the three. How about Eugene Omaruyi?
And again, matchup zones can be tough for bigs to get good looks, but nevertheless, got to get him involved.
Meanwhile, for Oregon, Eugene Omaruyi, the leading scorer with a dozen and an easy deuce. Yeah, we got to remember, I mean, it is early season.
Yes.
And we're seeing some of those things that happen early in the season that you don't want.
To the little guy, and he drills it. You got to give some love to Mama Kalashvili's unselfishness.
And the steal. And the lob and the finish. after trailing by 10 in the first half. Kick, shot fake, steps in for the two-pointer and nets it. Amari Hardy.
A little bit more assertive offensively.
Miles Kale working the baseline, has it blocked from behind, has it in the corner. Spots up for three, it's a little bit short. Oregon's going to get it again, and Armour, he missed it, but it's right there to be finished. Trying to get it to him on the inbounds, and he's got it. Looked at the three, he's done a nice job giving it up, though, and finding the open man. Kale knocks down the three-pointer.
His arms are long.
That's a big loss for St. John's. I mean, Figueroa at 14.5 per game last year. Shavar Reynolds. Omaruyi, nothing but net. And there's Omaruyi in the post. Mamu checking him. Feeds Figueroa in the finish.
You're not thinking about attacking.
Long three, nets. Bounded, takes it all the way to the offensive end, but can't finish the finger roll. And now Oregon's got the numbers. Terry, spot up three. Got it.
In transition, I thought he should have ran to the rim, but instead he flared out to the line.
He's a freshman. Kale, got it. Marie guarded by Molson. Kicks it across to Duarte. Duarte from the corner, three-pointer. Allowed Ba to come in as a transfer. I'd probably never had any of these other
great
players.
Maybe that's what it is. I set the tone.
And speaking of Omaruyi, there you go. The largest lead of the night. Reynolds on the bounce, and it's a pass that
kind of mismatch. Oh, they got the switch now. Mamu Kalashvili on Omaruyi.
Marie, the little fadeaway. Missed it, but Figueroa is there for the putback.
Front line spot.
Reynolds has got a dozen. Oregon's advantage is 14. And Omaruyi with the easy one. Omaruyi with 18. Leading the way for Oregon. Samuel in double figures now with 11.
He's got potential.
Terry, the freshman, got it. I mean, there is no hesitation in this freshman.
He is confident.
Mamu, finally, with an easy one. What's even more amazing to me is, in regards to Mamu, is not just that he's only made two baskets, but he's only had five shots.
Yeah, he just hasn't been aggressive enough to mile. That's what he's taken about 17 and a half shots per game so far through three contests.
Big
for right now.
Molson looking for Mamu. He's got it. Kicks it to Roden. Reynolds for three. Hit it. Tonight than we saw Wednesday against Missouri. And a lot of it has had to do with this young man, LJ Figueroa. Missed that shot, but and then Roden actually tipped it in. Mamu trying to get in the paint and get the basket and the foul. And Kevin Willard not letting that technical stop him from voicing his displeasure on that no call.
I don't blame him. I thought that was an easy foul.
And Omaruyi under 2 minutes to play. Advantage is 14, and Reynolds drives it to the basket. Oregon being very patient offensively, and why not, as the drive to the basket and the finish from Amari Hardy. Quickly up the court, breaking the press. Omaruyi with the left hand.
Coaches watching this game are saying, are you kidding me?
Duarte with the exclamation point. Well, and Coach Altman's going to be very pleased, I got to believe. With the win, 83-70, the final. Oregon, ranked number 21 in the country, looked like it tonight. Looked like a top 25 team, and the final half a second will tick off as the Ducks move to 1-1 on the season.